Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about the first chapter of pharmaceutical organic chemistry second, that is the benzene. So before discussing the benzene, we are going to discuss about the what is mean by the organic compounds, what are the classes of the organic compounds, and where the benzene generally exists. Here, what is mean by the compounds? We already know that compounds are the substances which can be obtained by combination of the two or more elements. Now generally the compounds can be classified into two types, inorganic compounds and the organic compounds. We generally deals about the organic compounds only. Now what is mean by the organic compounds? Various definitions are there. So initially the organic compounds can be considered as the compounds which can be obtained from the living organism. But nowadays we can say that organic compounds are the compounds which contains carbon atom as the main elements. Now here the organic compounds can be classified into two types. First one is the acyclic compounds, which can also called as the open chained compounds. Second one is the cyclic compounds, which can also considered as the closed chain compounds. Acyclic compounds are the compounds which contain open chain of the carbon atoms, and the cyclic compounds are the compounds which contain the closed chain of the carbon atoms, in which first carbon atom and the last carbon atoms are linked to each other. Acyclic compounds are again classified into two types, saturated compounds and the unsaturated compounds. In the saturated compounds, all the carbon atoms are linked to each other by a single covalent bond only. But in the unsaturated compound, carbon atoms are linked to each other by a carbon-carbon double or triple bond. They contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond or at least one carbon-carbon triple bond. Whether saturated and unsaturated compounds are either straight chained compounds or they are the branched chain compounds. Now in the cyclic compounds, these are the compounds in which the first carbon atom and last carbon atoms are linked to each other to form the cycle or to form the ring. Cyclic compounds are classified into two types. First one is the carbocyclic compounds and the second one is the heterocyclic compounds. In the carbocyclic compound, the cycle or the ring structure is generally made up of only carbon atom. But in the heterocyclic compound, the ring structure is generally made up of carbon atom along with one or more hetero atoms like nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, halogens or any other elements. Now the carbocyclic compounds are again classified into two types. First one is the alicyclic compound and second one is the aromatic compounds. In the alicyclic compound, all the carbon atoms are linked to each other by a single covalent bond, or in some alicyclic compound they contain carbon-carbon double bond also. In the aromatic compound, they have the specific character, and in this chapter we are going to discuss about the aromatic compounds only. So before discussing the benzene, we have to discuss about the aromatic compounds. Now what is mean by the aromatic compounds? There are various ways by which we can define the aromatic compounds. Now initially, the compounds which contain the aroma smell can be considered as the aromatic compound. Aroma smell means the pleasant smell. Later, various non-aromatic compounds were identified having the aroma smell. So the definition can be changed. Nowadays, we can say that the compounds which contain one or more benzene ring in their structure can be considered as the aromatic compounds. But again, here, so many compounds are there which does not contain the benzene ring, but they are the aromatic compounds. So nowadays, we can say that the compounds which can follow the Haeckel rule, they can be considered as the aromatic compound, whether they are the non-aromatic compound. But aromatic compound have the typical properties. Here, the compounds, if the unsaturated compound any double or triple bond, this generally shows the addition reaction. But the benzene or another aromatic compounds are there, they contain the double bonds in their structure, but they does not show the addition reaction. They show the substitution reaction rather than the addition reaction. And this typical property of the compound can be considered aromaticity. Which is the first compound identified as the aromatic compound? Yes, it is the benzene. Benzene is the first aromatic compound identified. Therefore, we can say that the compounds which contain one or more benzene ring in their structure can be considered as the aromatic compound. Let us start the benzene. Here, the molecular formula of the benzene is the C6H6. It means that benzene generally contains the 6 carbon atom and the 6 hydrogen atoms. There are various ways by which we can represent the benzene. First one is the Kekulé structure and second one is the resonance hybrid structure. There are three ways by which we can represent the benzene or the structure of the benzene. So as like in the aromatic compound, In each aromatic compound, we generally consider about the structure of that aromatic compound, preparation methods of that aromatic compound, physical properties, chemical properties, and the orientation as well as the uses of that aromatic compound. As like that, in the benzene, we generally discuss about the structure of the benzene, physical properties of the benzene, preparation methods of the benzene, chemical properties of the benzene. Lastly, we generally discuss about the orientations of the benzene and the uses of the benzene. So these are the representations of the ones. First two structures are about the Kekulé structure, third one is the resonance hybrid structure, and the fourth one is the complete structure of the benzene. In the structure of the benzene, generally two structures of the benzene can be considered. First one is the orbital structure and second one is the resonance structure. In the orbital structure, we generally consider about the formation of the carbon, formation of the sigma bond, formation of the pi bond, and in the resonance structure, the resonating structures of the benzene can be considered. So initially, we generally discuss about the orbital structures. Now in the orbital structure, we already known that the molecular formula of the benzene is C6H6. It means that 6 carbon atoms and the 6 hydrogen atoms are present in the benzene. In the benzene, carbon atom and hydrogen atoms are generally linked to each other by a single covalent bond, as well as in the benzene, all the carbon atoms are linked to each other by alternate single and double bonds here. So let us will discuss about the formation of these single bond and these double bonds in the benzene. Benzene may carbon-carbon single bond or carbon-hydrogen single bond or carbon-carbon double bond. Kaise tayar kiya jata hai, hum discuss karne wale the. So generally, in the formation of the bonds, generally orbitals take part. So in certain elements, a simple orbitals take part in the formation of the chemical bond, but in some elements, the hybrid orbital generally takes part in the formation of the chemical bond. So in the benzene, the hydrogen atom contains only one s orbital, but the carbon atom is generally sp2 hybridized. So hybridization of the carbon atom in the benzene is sp2 hybridization. Each carbon atom generally contains 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals. One sp2 hybrid orbitals on each carbon atom overlap with each other to form the carbon-carbon single bond. Here, har carbon ka ek sp2 hybrid orbital आपस में ओवरलैप होता है और कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड तैयार करता है यहाँ पर. सिमिलरली वी जनरली ऑब्जर्व कार्बन हाइड्रोजन सिग्मा बॉन्ड आल्सो इन द बेंजीन. सो हियर रिमेनिंग वन sp2 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल ऑफ ईच कार्बन एटम ओवरलैप विथ वन s ऑर्बिटल ऑफ ईच हाइड्रोजन एटम टू फॉर्म द कार्बन हाइड्रोजन सिंगल कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड. हर एक कार्बन का जो बचा हुआ एक sp2 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल है वो हाइड्रोजन एटम के s ऑर्बिटल से ओवरलैप करता है और कार्बन हाइड्रोजन में सिंगल बॉन्ड सिंगल कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड. नो हियर ऑल द प्रोड्यूस्ड सिंगल कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड इन द बेंजीन जनरली लाइज इन द सेम प्लेन. यहाँ पर देखिए हर एक कार्बन का एक sp2 ऑर्बिटल आपस में ओवरलैप हो रहा है और हियर कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड तैयार किया जाता है. बचा हुआ एक sp2 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल हर कार्बन एटम का हाइड्रोजन एटम के एस ऑर्बिटल के साथ ओवरलैप होता है और कार्बन हाइड्रोजन में सिंगल कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड तैयार किया. सो हियर कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड एंड कार्बन हाइड्रोजन सिंगल बॉन्ड कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड. बट जितने भी सिंगल कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड बेंजीन में तैयार किए हुए हैं वो सेम प्लेन में रहते हैं. सो दिस इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड एज वेल एज द कार्बन हाइड्रोजन सिंगल बॉन्ड. तो अभी हमने देखा कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड एंड कार्बन हाइड्रोजन सिंगल बॉन्ड कैसे तैयार होता है, वो सेम प्लेन में रहता है, ये भी हमने देखा. लेकिन ये कार्बन कार्बन पाई बॉन्ड कैसे तैयार होता है ये भी हमें देखना पड़ेगा. सो जब भी हाइब्रिडाइजेशन होता है यहाँ पर sp3 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन में 1s ऑर्बिटल और 3p ऑर्बिटल्स आपस में ओवरलैप होते हैं और sp3 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन दिखाते हैं 4sp3 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स तैयार किए जाते हैं. बट इन द sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ओनली 1s ऑर्बिटल एंड ओनली 2p ऑर्बिटल्स कैन ओवरलैप विथ ईच अदर टू फॉर्म द 3sp2 हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स. रिमेंबर दैट ओनली 2p ऑर्बिटल्स दैट इज द px ऑर्बिटल एंड द p ऑर्बिटल्स कैन ओवरलैप विथ ईच अदर. But now pz orbital should be remain as such. So carbon atom in the benzene is sp2 hybridized. It means that each carbon atom in the benzene should contain one unhybridized p orbital. Benzene में जितने भी carbon atom हैं उस हर कार्बन एटम के पास एक अनहाइब्रिडाइज्ड पी ऑर्बिटल रहता है बिकॉज इट शोज ओनली एसपी टू हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. सो वन अनहाइब्रिडाइज्ड पी ऑर्बिटल ऑन ईच कार्बन एटम ओवरलैप विथ ईच अदर टू फॉर्म द कार्बन कार्बन पाई बॉन्ड, दैट इज द कार्बन कार्बन पाई मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल. वी नोन दैट द पी और हाफ पार्ट ऑफ द पी ऑर्बिटल लाइज अबो द प्लेन ऑफ द सिग्मा बॉन्ड, हाफ पार्ट ऑफ द पी ऑर्बिटल लाइज बिलो द प्लेन ऑफ द सिग्मा बॉन्ड. डियर फोर हाफ पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोड्यूस्ड पाई मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल लाइज अबो द प्लेन ऑफ द सिग्मा बॉन्ड एंड अनदर हाफ पार्ट लाइज बिलो द प्लेन ऑफ द सिग्मा बॉन्ड. पी ऑर्बिटल जो रहता है उसका हाफ पार्ट सिग्मा बॉन्ड के अबो रहता है, अनदर हाफ पार्ट सिग्मा बॉन्ड के बिलो रहता है. डियर फोर जो भी पाई मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल तैयार होते हैं यहाँ पर, उस पाई मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल के हाफ पार्ट सिग्मा बॉन्ड के प्लेन के अबो रहते हैं, अनदर पार्ट सिग्मा बॉन्ड के प्लेन के बिलो रहते हैं. सो इन दिस वे इन द कार्बन एटम कार्बन कार्बन पाई बॉन्ड्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड. सो दैट द सिंपल शॉर्ट हैंड रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द बेंजीन इज सिंपली अ हेक्सागॉन विथ अ सर्कल इनसाइड. सर्कल रिप्रेजेंट द पाई मॉलिक्यूलर orbital because each and every carbon atom in the benzene experiences a double bond character. So simply हम एक hexagon निकालते हैं, उसके अंदर circle निकालते हैं, circle represent the pi molecular orbital. Now the second structure is the resonance structure. So according to the resonance theory we can also explain the structure of each and every aromatic compound. Similarly benzene is the resonance hybrid of the following two canonical forms. So first two structure are the canonical forms of the benzene. They are the alternating structure. They can be converted into each other. But these two are not actual structure. Actual structure lies between these two structure. And that actual structure is can be considered as the resonance hybrid structure of the benzene. So the third structure is the resonance hybrid structure of the benzene, which is the resonance hybrid of alternating these two canonical forms. Here is the assignment for you on the structure of the benzene.